Hi students, welcome to Learning Social Science. In the previous class, we have discussed economic chapter, sectors of economy. Today, I would like to explain the political science topic, Independent India, first 30 years, that is 1947 to 77. We know very well, we got our independence in the year 1947. Okay, from the independence onwards, first 30 years, that is called up to 77. In all these 30 years of age, in all these 30 years of period, what had happened in our country? What changes occurred in our country? Today, we are going to discuss. This chapter is very important for CBSE 10th class board examinations, as well as Andhra Pradesh 10th class board examinations and Telangana board exams also. This is useful for NTSC like school level competitive examinations, NTSC level 1 and level 2 also. And also these are very important topics we are going to discuss for the competitive examinations for the aspirants. Finally, our topic is Independent India. In this Independent India, first 30 years, today we are going to discuss. On 26th January 1950, we are going to enter into life of contradictions in politics. We will have equality and in social and economic life, we will have inequality. In politics, we will be recognizing in the principle of one man, one vote, and one vote, one value. Who said these words? Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. According to Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's opinion, in our country, in the political life, according to this one principle, one man, one vote, and one vote, one value, according to this principle, we are getting political equality. Still now, some social and economic inequalities are going on. We know very well this 26th January 1950. Dear students, do you know what is the importance of 1950, 26th January? On the day that our constitution came into force, we celebrate this day as Republic Day. Republic Day. What is Republic Day? Republic means head of the country is directly or indirectly elected by the people, that then the country is known as Republic country. For example, we take India, the head of our country is the President of India. The President of India is indirectly elected by the people once in every five years. So that's why India is a republic country. For example, Britain is not a republic country. Britain is not a republic country still now. The head of the Britain is either king or queen. On the basis of a hereditary process, they are entering into that position. So that's why Britain is not a republic still now. So that is, dear children, we know very well our constitution came into force in the year 1950. At the time, the constitution sought to fulfill multiple goals at a time. What are the goals in front of our leadership at the time? So what are the goals? The first one is making of democracy. Second one is unification and creation of a single political community, massive social and economic changes. What is making of democracy? In front of our leadership, it was a one of the goal, making of democracy. They want to introduce democracy in our country. We know very well, democracy means in the democracy, people are the rulers, people are the lawmakers, people are the ultimate in this democracy. They wanted to introduce this democracy. It was one of the goals in front of our leadership at the time of constitution came into force. The second one is unification and creation of a single political community. At the time of independence, India was under the control of 550 above princely states. Most of the area was under their control only. So from their control to unify the total country and to create a single political unity, it was one of the other goals of constitution. The next one is massive social and economic changes. At the time, in the society, inequalities were there, economic inequalities were there, political inequalities were there. So they wanted to change all these political changes, social changes, as well as economic changes. Dear students, all these are the challenges in front of our leadership. What are the challenges? Unity and integrity, it was the first challenge. The second is social and economic transformation. The third one is work of the democratic system. All these three are the major challenges. All these challenges are interrelated one to another. All the unity and integrity, at the time India was not integrated. So many kingdoms were there. And second one is social and economic transformation. In the there is inequalities socially, economically, so many were there. So that's why they want to set right. It was also one of the challenges. The next one is work of democratic system. These three are the major challenges in front of our leadership. All these are interrelated one to another. The first general elections to be held according to new constitution, it was the path of our democratic system. The first general elections are very, very important in our Indian democratic system. We have adopted universal adult franchise for the first general elections onwards. For in the Western countries, one after another, stage after stage, they provided a universal adult franchise. But in our country, for the first time only, the Constitution of India provides universal adult franchise. Universal means what? For all. Universal means for all. Adult means, according to Indian Constitution, at present, those who are completed 18 years of age. 18 years of age. Franchise means right to vote. Franchise means right to vote. Right to vote for all the people, those who are Indian citizens, those who are completed 18 years of age, automatically they get right to vote irrespective of their gender, caste, or region, or religion. That is called universal adult franchise. We have adopted this universal adult franchise for the first general elections only in the year 1952. For example, in the Switzerland, they got the women of Switzerland, they got right to vote in the year 1971. But our Indian women got right to vote in the year 1952 for the first general elections only. Dear children, do you know how many types of elections are there? We know only three types of elections. The first one is general elections. The second one is midterm elections. The third one is by-election. What is meant by general elections? If the elections are conducting between the regular intervals, for all the seats, to fill all the seats are the most of the seats. If the elections are conducting to fill all the seats or the most of the seats between two regular intervals. In our country, the regular intervals for general elections in our country is 5 years. The second is midterm elections. If the elections are conducting between two general elections to fill all the seats or the most of the seats, then it is called midterm elections. Again, if the elections are conducting between the two general elections to fill almost all the seats or the majority of the seats, then it is called midterm elections. The third one is by-election. By-election means it is also conducting, elections are conducting between the two regular elections or two general elections, but it is to fill one or few vacant seats only. To fill one or few vacant seats, if the elections are conducting in that particular constituencies only, between the two general elections, this is called by election. Dear children, up to now, how many general elections were conducting in India, do you know? Yes, we have conducted up to now 17 general elections in our country. 17 general elections in our country. In which years all these general elections were conducted? Just like a phone number, we can easily remember 272-7170-4916-89-4949. Again, I repeat, 272-7170-4916-89-4949. The first two indicates 1952. The first two indicates 1952. The next is 1957, 1962, 1967, 1971, 1977, 1980, 1984, 1989, 1991, 1996, 1998, 1999, 2004, 2009, 2014, 2019. In all these years, we have conducted up to now 17 general elections. Just like a small code 272-7170-4916-89-4949. For the first general elections were conducted in our country in the year 1952. Recent elections were conducted in our country was in the last year, that is 2019. The first general elections were very important in our Indian democracy. At the same time, the first general elections were too difficult also, because at that time, so many social dimensions were there in our country. A large section of the people, they were illiterates. Illiteracy was one of the major problems then. The second one is male domination. Male domination. These two are the major problems to conduct the first general elections. Majority of the people, they were illiterates. They did not know what was elections at the time. They did not know how to choose their candidate, those who are contesting in that particular elections. And moreover, at the time of independence in the year 1947, Our literacy rate was only 12%. According to 1951 census, our literacy rate was 18%. So, at the time, the people, most of the people, they did not know about elections. They did not know to choose their candidate also because of illiteracy. The second problem is male domination. so many women, they had no independent identity at the time. They were known by their fathers or their husbands. These two were the major problems. At the time, the responsibility was taken by the conduction of elections. Responsibility was taken by Election Commission of India. Indian Election Commission, record Election Commission of India, Election Commission of India. This Election Commission, according to Article 324, Indian Election Commission was set up by the Constitution of India. The first Election Commissioner of India was Mr. Sukumar Sen, at present Chief Election Commissioner of India. Chief Election Commissioner of India is Sunil Arora. Dear children, Election Commission is an autonomous body. It was formed in the year 1950. It takes the responsibility of conducting free and fair elections in our country. At the time, the first Election Commissioner of India was Mr. Sukumar Sen. At present, Chief Election Commissioner of India is Mr. Sunil Arora. Dear children, who is the Chief Election Commissioner of India at present? Mr. Sunil Arora. According to 324 article of our Indian Constitution, this autonomous body was arranged by the Constitution of India. At the same time, the state election commissions are also there. According to 243K and Z articles, state election commissions were set up by the Constitution of India. Already we have discussed, dear students, so many difficulties were there in the conduction of first general elections. Already we have discussed, the first one is illiteracy, the second one is male domination. To make it easier, the Election Commission came to a novel idea having in our everyday's life. So the Election Commission of India allotted different types of symbols which are in everyday life to the contesting candidates. Still now the Election Commission of India is doing the same. Make it easier, in the first elections, they allot one box, they stuck their symbol outside of the box. At that time, almost the voters were illiterates. They did not know how to cast their vote. So that's why just they dropped their ballot paper in any one of the boxes. That indicates that the casting of the vote is over in the first general elections. The conduction of elections free and fair manner in our country is a gigantic process. So many stages are there in the conduction of elections in our country. Dear children, conduction of elections in our country is a gigantic process. Large process is there. So many stages are also there in the conduction of elections in our country. The first stage is preparatory stage. According to People's Representative Act, the Election Commission of India conduct elections. The second one is Election Commission. The Election Commission prepares electoral roll before conducting elections. Any type of legislative assembly elections or the Lok Sabha elections. What is electoral roll? The list of eligible voters in that particular constituency or in the district level, that is called electoral roll or voters list. The third one is nominations. the interesting candidates here, two types of interesting candidates are there. Some are independent candidates, some are party candidates. They submit their nominations towards returning officers of that particular constituency level. After some time, withdrawals of the nominations is also there. The candidates, those who lost their interest in contesting elections, they withdraw their nominations from the returning officer. The next one is ballot paper. Nowadays, EVMs, electronic voting machines, we are using. In the ballot paper, the total contesting candidates' names against to their names, their symbols are also printed. Instead of ballot paper, now the Election Commission of India uses the electronic voting machines for voting. The next one is arrangements. So, elaborate arrangements were needed in India because of to conduct the free and fair elections all over the India is elaborate arrangements were compulsory. Next, on particular day, the eligible voters, they cast their vote to their interesting candidates. The last one is announcement of the results. After few days, the Election Commission of India announced the result. The majority votes, those who got the majority votes, they will announce they are the winning candidate in that particular elections. Dear children, all these are the different stages. Again, I repeat, the first one is preparatory stage, the second one is election commission's work, the third one is nominations, fourth one is withdrawal of the nominations, the next one is ballot paper or EVMs, elaborate arrangements, the next one is voting, the last one is announcement of the results. All these are the different stages in the conduction of elections in our country. In the first elections, 1952, 1957, next 1962, next 1967, in all these elections, continuously one party dominance we have seen in our Indian political system. First, we discuss, dear children, according to 1952 general elections, which parties were participated in that elections, how many seats were won by them, first we discuss. The first one is Congress party got 364 seats. Independents all over India only 37. Communist Party of India won by 16 seats. Socialist Party won by 12 seats. Kisan Mazdoor Praja Party only 9 seats. People's Democratic Party only, it won by 7 seats only. Ganatantra Parishat 6 seats. Others 38. All these parties, more than 5 seats won in the first general elections, which was conducted in the year 1952. What we have observed from this table is, Congress party won majority of the seats in our country in the first elections. No other political party did not get at least 11% of the votes cast at the time. Only the Congress party won 45% of the seats won by the Congress party. Nearly 70% of the seats won by the Congress party itself. No other party. What we observe from this is, no other political party was nearer to the Congress party than. through this first general elections, Jawaharlal Nehru became the first Prime Minister of India. We can see what we observe is one party dominance. Only that is the Congress party dominance we have seen in all the first, second, third continuous elections in our Indian political system. Dear children, we have seen already in the first general elections and the seats won by different political parties. Now, one more example we are going to be seeing. In 1962 elections, general elections, Congress won 361 seats, Communists won 29, Independents won only 20 seats, Swatantra Party won 18 seats, next 14 seats won by Janasangh Party, 12 seats won by Praja Socialist Party, 7 seats were won by DMK, 6 seats won by Socialist Party, 27 seats won by others. Here also more than 5 seats won by different political parties only we have mentioned here. Here again we have observed again the dominant political party in this elections was also Congress party only. 361 seats won by the Congress. So after few decades, 2 and 3 decades, remaining political parties slowly raised their voice. According to first 3 general elections, Congress party won 70% of the seats in our Lok Sabha. No other party did not reach that, so that's why remaining political parties they were unable to challenge the Congress party and the Congress system at the time. After few decades, remaining political parties they have raised their support. And Congress allowed them to form the government. Yes, it was not undemocratic situation was occurred in our country. So that's why multi-party system was started. At present, at Election Commission of India, 2,599 political parties are there in our country. So India is following multi-party democracy. For example, we take in USA only 2 political parties are the major political parties in USA. In China, single political party. In Russia, single political party. In British, 2 political parties. But in our country, we have followed multi-party democracy. At present, at Election Commission of India, 2,599 political parties are there. Out of these 2,599 political parties, some are national parties, some are regional parties, are the state parties, are the local parties.
విద్యార్థులను టాపర్స్ గా ర్యాంకర్స్ గా తీర్చిదిద్దడంలో శ్రీ చైతన్య స్కూల్ ఎప్పుడూ వారితో ఉంటుంది. 9th నుంచి 10th గ్రేడ్ కి ప్రమోట్ అయ్యే తెలుగు రాష్ట్రాల విద్యార్థులతో పాటు ఇతర రాష్ట్రాల విద్యార్థులకు మరియు సిబిఎస్ఈ విద్యార్థులకు ఒక గొప్ప అవకాశం. శ్రీ చైతన్య స్కూల్ టీవీ క్లాసెస్, శ్రీ చైతన్య స్కూల్ ఆన్లైన్ క్లాసెస్, శ్రీ చైతన్య స్కూల్ ఆన్లైన్ ఎగ్జామ్స్, ఇంకా శ్రీ చైతన్య స్కూల్ ర్యాంక్ గురు యాప్.
6, 7, 8, 9 తరగతుల విద్యార్థులకు ఎన్టీఎస్ఈతో పాటు జాతీయ స్థాయిలోని అన్ని ఒలింపియాడ్స్ కు, ఐఐటి మరియు నీట్ ఫౌండేషన్ కు ఈ ప్రోగ్రాంలు ఎంతో ఉపయోగకరం. వివరాలకు www.sreechaitanyaschool.net.